It's pretty simple when you have an amphibious vehicle, which is pretty much everything except for pretty much all of the Russian-Ukrainian vehicles, except for things like trucks and stuff like that, and tanks. They just give them a movement order on it, and they'll work. Yeah, Raptor, sorry you missed it. Yes, I will be putting this up on YouTube right away, so you effectively didn't miss anything. Let's go ahead and... move these tanks somewhere. Let's put them somewhere where they can shoot at something. Not sure if they'll actually even get to spot anything. Oh, there we go. I can just stick them right on the shoreline. Let's see what these tanks see. Probably nothing. I'm not sure if anything... I haven't actually played the scenario, so I'm not sure what's going to happen. I think these guys... Here we go. Oh, did this one bog? He bogged trying to get out of the... get into the water. Whoops. There is always that risk. Bogged on the riverbed. Before it started floating. So yeah, it's pretty simple, really. You just, you know, move them onto the water. And they do their thing. They are limited to a pretty slow speed, though. And if it gets knocked out, you will lose everyone in it if it doesn't... if the water is too deep. Yeah, nothing sees me. Pretty quiet start. Well, it'd be kind of a... be pretty bad to do an assault crossing contested with things shooting at you. Infantry can get out of it as long as they... Oh, it fixed itself. Infantry can get out of it as long as the water is shallow enough. Yeah, you do not want to have anyone shooting at you while you do this. That's just a bad day. Yeah, but it looks like this, it looks like there's not actually going to be any fighting until you get further inland. You cross it and get inland. Maybe. I don't know. I mean, who knows? Maybe they will, maybe they won't. Maybe once you get closer in the river, they might have a order to not start shooting at you till you get halfway across it or something. So yeah, anyways, that's the amphibious capability. Let's see, what else have we got here? Ah yes, electronic warfare. Okay. It's just going to show we do have some smaller maps, too. It's not all giant ones. This looks so out of place with these World War II vehicles sitting here. Can't wait to get those replaced with some real new art. Oh yeah, new briefing graphics. We went back to using NATO symbols, but since I know not everyone can understand them, we'll always have a key here so you can understand what they mean. And for the support panel, you don't really need a key because it says right there what it is next to the symbol. Alright, oh yeah, this is a BTR-70 with no texture yet. That's just a quick placeholder texture. Here's the trucks, though. Those got textured. Okay, anyways, yeah, so smaller maps. There's definitely some smaller ones, as you can see here. Still working on some of the roofs here, so I know they look a little bit Normandy-ish right now, but the 3D artist is working on the roofs right now, actually, so... Yep. Oh yeah, here's some modern bridges. We've also got some big 600-meter ones, too. I remember in Shock Force having to... I remember in Shock Force having to make those weird land bridge things with the elevations because we didn't have any proper bridges. It's weird how simple little things like that are missed. Alright, so let's do electronic warfare. So I know exactly how I'm going to do this. We're going to go to... Was it AR demo? We're going to go ahead and pick up that scenario I was using for the demo. Alright, so, electronic warfare, you do it down here in data. You can also set it in quick battles, too. It's basically a data setting here, like an environmental setting. Light, medium, strong are the possible settings, and you can use them on both sides, or for none, or, you know, just one, or whatever. Light is going to interfere with things like GPS and handheld radios, low-powered stuff. It is also going to interfere with UAVs. Medium is going to pretty much shut down everything but powerful radios and you know, vehicle-mounted stuff. And strong basically shuts everything down. You'll still have access to off-map assets, but they take ridiculously long, like 20 minutes to half an hour, to even start adjusting and spotting. So they pretty much become, at that point, you're like, if you're at strong levels of electronic warfare, which is basically completely shut down, you might as well be World War II Italian infantry from Fortress Italy, is basically what it's like. One of the scenarios, actually, for the US campaign I'm making has that premise in there. You get all your Abrams and Bradleys and all that stuff, but the Russians have hit the area with a heavy electronic warfare effort for their attack, and you're working with no comms. You have no fire support, nothing. You just have to work with, you know, your command and communications network is basically Italian infantry levels from Fortress Italy. So yeah, everything's shut down, no contact. I'd have to open them up so they can actually look at each other and, you know, do hand signals. You can still call in. You know, stuff is pre-planned, but you'll notice later delays are huge. 25 minutes to call in artillery support. Something you can surprise your quick battle opponent with either. It's something you need to agree on beforehand because you set it up in the settings beforehand. But it leads to, I think, some fun things. You could play your quick battle opponent and say, okay, let's just shut everything off. You know, just run this like it's World War II kind of thing. The bridges. I really like these giant bridges. I think these things are fun. Whoops, that's not the right one. There it is. Bilko, sorry, I think you missed it, but you can watch this afterwards, or I'm gonna put it up on YouTube, and you can watch it there without having to worry about, lag or anything like that. EMCK, yes, there are trenches. There are foxholes and trenches and TRPs and all that good stuff from World War II. Or from the, from the earlier titles that was introduced since Shock Force. So yeah, I love the giant bridges. You can make some pretty interesting scenarios with these. U.S. campaign last mission actually will have an assault going across one of these bridges.